Brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, this month of Ramadan, month of blessing, thus we finished. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has accepted our ibadah of Ramadan. As you know, Salafus Salihin used to pray or making dua 6 months continuously, O Allah, you accept our Ramadan deeds. Once Ramadan is finished, you'll see many people used to come to the masjid, they are no more here. No more, they are no more anymore. You'll not see them in the masjid. They were running for Tarawih every night. Now you don't see them coming for the Salah in Jama'ah. Umar radiallahu anhu was giving khutbah one day. قَرَعَ عُمَرَ بْنُ خَطَّبُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ وَهُوَ يَخْطُبُ النَّاسَ عَلَى الْمِنْبَرِ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُوا عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. The meaning of this verse, indeed, those who have said, our Lord is Allah, and they remain on a right course, the angels will descend upon them. The Mufassirun said, in the time of death, the angels will come to them and will tell him, do not fear and do not grieve, but receive good tidings of paradise which you are promised. Those who are firm in their deen, continue in the right path, the angels will come to give them good news in time of their death. Don't worry, you have the good news of Jannah. Who doesn't like among us to have this good news? After reciting this ayah, Umar radiallahu anhu said in the khutbah, "Istaqamu Allahi bita'ah, thumma lam yarugu rawghan al-tha'alab." These people who are mentioned in this verse of Surah Fussilat, ayah number 30, they were remaining firm on the right path, on the practice of the deen, and they were not dodging like the dodging of fox. You know how fox walk? Straight away. Like that? Never ever. Going this, that, looking like this. Never from on the straight path. So this is the example Umar radiallahu anhu put for people to understand. A believer continues. Is he all steadfast, firm in the right path? That's why many of the Salafus Salihin said, لَيْسَ لِعَمَلِ الْمُؤْمِنِ غَايَةٌ دُونَ الْمَوْتِ. The believer has no end of his deeds, righteous deeds, except the mouth. Only death will stop him, nothing else. Then they recited the Quranic verse, وَعَبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. And worship your Lord until there comes to you the certainty. And the certainty is death. Why? Today, about grave life, about life of Jannah and Jahannam, all mentioned, but it doesn't go in that deeply to our heart and our mind, but once death, people will face time of death, they will see everything, then it will be certain, their belief will be firm at that time, they will see the reality of everything. There will be no doubt in their mind anymore. So, worship your Lord until there comes to you the certainty, that means you continue to worship Allah, you never give it up. Never think to have a long break from there. There is no break for the believer of 5 daily prayer and all other obligatory duties. That's why Hasan al-Basri, rahmatullah alayhi, great imam, he said, Abal qawmul mudawama. Many Muslim, many people didn't want to remain firm and continue in their ibadah with Allah. Wallahi mal mu'minu billadhi ya'malu shahra aw shahrayn aw aaman aw aamayn. La wallahi. مَا جُعِلَ لِعَمَلِ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَجَلٌ دُونَ الْمَوْتِ. A believer never worship Allah just a month or two, neither a year or two. There is no break, there is no stoppage for the believer to be away from his relationship with Allah and his ibadah of Allah, except the mouth. Only death will stop him. Nothing will stop him from his relationship with Allah, his ibadah of Allah. That's why the whole purpose of our creation, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. Haven't created jinn and insan except to worship me. This is our main job. This is our main goal. And the Salafi Salihin said also, وَإِنَّ مِنْ أَمَرَاتِ قَبُولِ الْحَسَنَةِ الْحَسَنَةَ بَعْدَهَا. The sign of one's righteous deed was accepted, our righteous deed of ibadah, of Ramadan is accepted. You want to know the sign your one is accepted? Then you will be doing more righteous deed after Ramadan. You continue, then this is a sign your ibadah is accepted. وَإِنَّ مِنْ عَلَامَاتِ بُطْلَانِ الْعَمَلِ وَرَدِّهِ عَلَى صَاحِبِهِ الْعَوْدَ إِلَى الْمَعَاصِي بَعْدَ الطَّاعَاتِ. And sign of somebody's amal deed, his ibadah is rejected by Allah and not accepted, that he's gone back to commit the sin as he was before Ramadan. There is no improvement in him in the Ramadan. This is a sign his Ramadan ibadah is not accepted. So, brothers and sisters, we need to continue. And this is our main function, main purpose of our creation. And that's why continuation is in hadith, even though its amount is little, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أحب الأعمال إلى الله تعالى أدوامها وإن قل. The acts most pleasing to Allah are those which are done continuously, even if they are small. And when somebody does in Ramadan in the season too much, and after that nowhere, then this kind of action and amal Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like. One of the amal we continue is the fasting of amal, fasting amal after Ramadan continues. That's why immediately 6 days of fasting, man sama Ramadan, thumma atba'ahu sitta min shawwal, kana ka siyam ad-dahr. He who observed fasting in the month of Ramadan and also observed as fasting for 6 days in the month of Shawwal, it is as if he has observed fasting for the whole year. So alhamdulillah, 29th day we fasted last month. And now 6 days will be not difficult. Even whole year, not only in Shawwal. The weekly fasting of Monday and Thursday, the Sunnah one, and Ayyam will be the white days, middle of the month, 13, 14, and 15, are Sunnah days, also whole year. So if somebody had this habit, subhanAllah, he is in fasting in whole year, subhanAllah. That should be our target. Those who are able to fast 29 days in one go should have this, inshallah, confidence that we can carry on even after Ramadan. We have been praying Taraweeh. Where is the Farad prayer today? The most important amal in our life is the Farad one. Taraweeh was Sunnah. And daily five daily prayer is Farad. Which one is more important to Allah? In Hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَبْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. My servant draws not near to me with anything more loved by me than the obligatory duties I have enjoined upon him. Of course, in the same hadith of Qudsi, he continues to say, وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرُّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. And my servant continues to draw near to me with nawafil ibadah, with additional ibadah, so that I should love him. So we start seriously with our fard one, and we go for the nafal as well. And if we do continue pray fard salah in jama'ah regularly, we don't miss the fard one, then we have an agreement with Allah that he will give us Jannah, in a hadith. If somebody doesn't pray regularly five daily prayer, he has no agreement with Allah for Jannah. It's wish of Allah, may punish him, may forgive him. And praying in jama'ah is so good. In a hadith, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى لله 40 يوما في جماعة يدرك التكبيرة الأولى كتبت له براءتان براءة من النار وبراءة من النفاق. Whoever performs salah, five daily prayer for Allah for 40 days in congregation, catching the first takbir, two absolutions are written for him. One absolution is absolution from the hellfire, other one is the absolution from hypocrisy. Allah will save him from the hypocrisy. If somebody has a habit praying regularly in Jama'ah, now he's gone to travel somewhere, or became ill, even bedbound for many months or years, he could not come anymore to the masjid, while he was well, used to come regularly, for him such a good news. In hadith, إِذَا مَرِضَ الْعَبْدُ أَوْ سَافَرَ كُتِبَ لَهُ مِثْلُ مَا كَانَ يَعْمَلُ مُقِيمًا صَحِيحًا. When a slave of Allah suffers from illness or sets on a journey, he is credited with the equal of whatever good works he used to do when he was healthy or at home. So the man regularly used to pray in the masjid in Jama'ah, old salah. Now he's ill for 5 years, 7 years, cannot come to the masjid. All the year he's praying on his bed, lying down on his bed. He will be rewarded each salah, each rakah, not one, 25 or 27 times more. As if he's coming to the masjid to pray, while he's praying at his bed, lying down on his bed. Even if you have good intention, you regularly pray, but one day you miss tahajjud because you have intention, but you could not pray. You overslept. Also good news. مَا مِنْ إِمْرِئٍ تَكُونُ لَهُ صَلَاةٌ بِلَيْلٍ يَغْلِبُهُ عَلَيْهَا نَوْمٌ إِلَّا كُتِبَ لَهُ أَجْرُ صَلَاتِهِ وَكَانَ نَوْمُهُ عَلَيْهِ صَدَقَةٌ. Any person who offers prayer at night regularly, it is his habit, but on a certain night he is dominated by sleep, overslept, will be given the reward of praying. Why he overslept, could not pray, because of his regular habit, while he missed this night, he is getting the reward of the salah. His sleep will be some kind of sadaqah from Allah. His reward is not missed. Can you see importance of istiqamah? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq, that we carry on this high spirit and we don't make it goes away from us. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim. Wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa al-dhikri al-hakim. Wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al-muslimin min kulli dhanb. Fastaghfiru wa atubu ilayh. Innahu huwa al-ghafur rahim. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك وأصلي وأسلم على أفضل الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين أما بعد عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعلموا أن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وعليكم بالجماعة فإن يد الله مع الجماعة فصلوا على البشير النذير إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد وارض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون أبي بكر عمر عثمان وعلي وعن سائر أصحاب نبيك محمد أجمعين وعن الذين يتبعونهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك ومنك وكرمك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها مولاها اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم أحسن عاقبتنا في الأمور كلها وأجرنا من خزي الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة اللهم اغفر موتانا واشف مرضانا وارحمنا يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم ارحم على عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم احفظهم اللهم ارحمهم اللهم كن لهم عونا ونصيرا اللهم أهلك أعداءك أعداء الدين الذين يحاربون دينك ويقاتلون أولياءك اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر اللهم أنزل عليهم بأسك الذي لا ترده عن القوم المجرمين عباد الله اتقوا الله واذكروه يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة